This is Cousin Janice, and today she's going to teach Louise and I how to make pizza rustica, pizza gaina, meat pie, whatever you call it, it's delicious.
The beginning of my day shopping with Janice. Our first stop is Leone's in Union. This is Cousin Janice, and she's getting ready to help me make the Easter pies.
For two, 7, 14.
Next stop, Massimo's Deli.
Sorry. Coconuts for the meat pie, what else?
And,
olives? All right, okay, good.
Maybe sauce.
All right, we'll see.
And on to our last stop, Pastosa Ravioli in Westfield.
And we're on our way home. The bakery closed. What are you doing, Anaya? Who's that behind me? Who's that? Oh no, it's you. You don't like having your picture taken? Well, do a little dance or something. There you go.
You can just mix it in a mixer. If you have a mixer, or mix it by hand.
Now we're putting it, the Crisco, which should be cold.
Yes.
So while the crust sits in the refrigerator for a while, Louise is going to cut up the meat.
So that it's not overwhelming with anyone.
Mm-hmm.
So if you cut it in the strips like this, and then this is suicide. So I mean, that's how I cut mine.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Ansel used to do the same thing, but.
So Frank's working on his pond.
Okay.
This one that she's cutting now
is the Genoa salami.
Genoa salami.
Hot suicide. Parma. Parmicato ham.
Right. And
we didn't do the prosciutto.
We didn't do the prosciutto yet.
Put everything in there.
So all these ingredients, the meats and the other cheeses, are mixed in together. And we put in some mozzarella. So we're going to mix the ricotta cheese, basket cheese, and eggs in a mixer?
Yep.
Lightly or no?
Well, we're going to make it where it's creamy.
Okay.
Because, I don't think Aunt Sue ever put the ricotta in the mixer, but I think it makes it less lumpy.
Okay. You're probably wondering what we're doing at ShopRite, because Cousin Janice wasn't paying attention and we had too much ricotta cheese in there. So I was sent to buy two more baskets of basket cheese. I grabbed one and the old lady grabbed the other, and I had a kicker for it, so but I got what we needed.
Because the colder it is, the better it's going to be for the crispiness of the dough and also to roll it out.
So this was in the fridge for about an hour.
Right.
And you just floured the bottom of the...
Yeah. And if this isn't perfect, it doesn't make a difference. Because once you put it in the pan, you can just fix it.
Okay.
So, and then I'm just going to cut. Actually, I'm going to cut it and then use what I cut off to make the lattice top.
Meanwhile, Frank is still working on his goldfish pond.
Six. try to make them.
Once it's in the pan, this is an easy dough to batch.
What makes it easy to patch? Why?
Because it's soft.
Okay. What are you doing to the sides?
Well, what I'm hoping is that, and this dough is not, it's a good dough once it's cooked, but feel how soft it is already.
It is very soft.
It's very soft.
Good job, you did it.
You want it to be that soft? No.
No, not really. But, I mean, it is what it is. And the, to me, the sweet pie dough...
So you botched that up too, maybe?
No, no. I looked at purposely. Because I thought, oh, wait, this is a lot of Crisco. But it was one cup. So this is ready to have the stuff put in. But now we're going to have to do is I'm going to get a bigger pot.
Hi. Say hello. Hi, Teresa. Hi, Louise.
No.
Louise, turn around. Let me see your pretty smile.
No.
Sterling, my best girl.
Is that
the
top part?
Yeah.
They just lace it.
Yeah, but I don't know if we're going to have enough. Because if not, I think I'm going to cut some of this off.
What's that story?
The story is it was Aunt Sue's. And then when Aunt Sue passed away, we gave it to Nicholas. And as your mother has tried over the years to get a pan that was exactly like that, we never found one. Because as I was explaining to you before, the pan, the sides, both kind of went like this a little. They weren't straight. So it's very difficult to find one. I have the old board that they used to make ravioli on.
You put on wax paper.
Well, that's what I did this time because I think it'll be easier to get it off. Sugar.
How long in the oven for, Janice?
I think an hour. So you know what? Let's sit down and have a cup of coffee.
Sounds good.